Looking for me, I presume.
The child who glimpsed the truth.
No, it cannot be.
He cameth unto me, as didst thou. Alike in gifts, yet set upon different paths.
He speaks true, Warrior of Light. Like you, I have been blessed with the Echo. The visions terrified me at first. They came without warning. I wondered what I had done to deserve them, but I had no time to ponder such things once the calamity came. The land turned against us, and in a matter of hours, Falcon's Nest was buried under 10 fulms of ice and snow. We had no choice but to flee for Ishgard. We came to the wall, and while we searched for a way through, there was an avalanche. And then I was alone. So I set forth for Dravania. I knew full well what might happen where I found. But I could not survive on my own. I was found, of course. And not by a mere dragon, but by the great worm Hreisvalgr. And it was then that I knew why I had been given this gift. For with it I heard his voice. And saw the truth through his eyes. I was chosen to deliver this revelation to the people, to bring dragon and man together as they once were and should ever be. It wasn't supposed to be like that. You have to believe me. It was beyond my control. Children taught to fear the skies, who saw their loved ones slaughtered. Yet the Dravanians, though they know where the fault truly lies, fell upon them with such fury.
Men die, and their children forget. But we are everlasting. To us, then is as now. Thou canst not comprehend the violation, the outrage, the fury.
I will make this right. I am neither a saint nor a savior, just another sinner. Yet I will not forsake this cause. I cannot. I will see this cycle broken and peace restored. We can do naught else, for we are now as one.
Alright, we're actually getting into the story quite a bit. Master the Third.
Hmm. Might have to take a quick nap before work. What is the quest to get a flying mount in Heavensward? If anyone's updated it. Okay, so you do have to do.
Oh my god! Yes!
Upon an airship, conceived within the fecund mind of Sid Garland, renegade prodigy of Garlemald, would come to call Eorzea home. To the heavens, where isles of earth and stone floated as clouds. A frontier the knights of Ishgard had scarce begun to explore. To a fledgling outpost, within the sea of clouds, where careworn scouts ever scanned the skies for winged shadows